and in Rubbernecker's tour bus, the Grand Canyon's number one purveyor of fine bus tours.
I still don't see why we're going to their tour bus company.
Don't you see? All the tourists at the canyon that day my parents lost me, they had cameras. And you can't tell me in all those pictures they took, there won't be some that accidentally have me and my parents in them, man. The company left records of who used the tour that day.
But that was more than 10 years ago. Besides, they won't just hand the records over to us. We're just an Indian and some guy.
Uh-uh, man. You can't have no in your heart. No is not an option, brother. You're not just an Indian. You're kicking wing. All right? And one day you're going to be kicking wing animal doctor. And then you should change your name to kicking ass. I would. Oh, man. Swerve them potholes. You know, because the animal. One swing and this here ball peen hammer will trigger this A-bomb and it'll blow up the whole city, maybe even half the country. Now here's what I need. I need you to give me the records of everybody who toured the Grand Canyon on them buses June 13th, 1979. I'm not messing around. I hit it. And then it goes bang. All right? Now while I'm up here waiting, you... Show me them boobies.
Dang. Now even you like the way that chick looked, didn't you?
Well, even me? What's that supposed to mean, man?
Just say it. I'm beginning to doubt your hetero street credentials here. I mean, you're never putting the moves on Brandy.
Brandy, man? Well, she's too beautiful. She's way too hot for me.
He has no idea that Brandy even likes
his voice. It's so sexy.
I wonder what he looks like.
You're standing there with an atom bomb.
Could be fat man, could be little boy. We'll nail that down later. But anyway, did you get the names you wanted?
Yeah, I did. But by the way, it was no atom bomb. Turns out some skateboarder slapped a biohazard band sticker on the side of this septic tank for an RV. Anyway, cops knew it wasn't a bomb right away.
Yeah, who hasn't seen that scenario played out?
It's just an old crapper tank, people.
Oh! Oh, oh. Kicking wings! Stop it! Somebody help me! Help me! Is it done? I got the poo on me.
You are so pathetic.
Now, they decided not even to arrest me. They said being covered in that stinky stuff was punishment enough.
Don't you get it, man? Stinky stuff is your milieu, okay? This is your deal. You are an underachievement nexus in the universe, and it's always going to be like this, Joey.
No, man, but you got to keep going. What am I going to do, quit? That's not an option. You got to keep on keeping on. Life's a garden, dig it? You make it work for you. You never give up, man. That's my philosophy. You hear that in there?
And you know, the thing that drives me crazy and fascinates me at the same time is you are so unrelentingly upbeat about your plight. I need more, man. I'll be honest with you. I want to see you in here tomorrow. I want to hear more of the saga of Joe Dirt.
All right. Thanks, you guys.
All right, Joe.
Good morning, troops. This is Xander Kelly, and you, of course, are careening headlong into yet another hellish day in that tiny existence you
laughingly refer to in your life. I'm here with Joe Dirt. Joey, the tale could not be told in one day, and we've asked you back today. I might say the joint looks great. The toilets are freshly scrubbed. The floor is spick and span.
Hey, Joe, did you use the stuff with the tiny scrubbing bubbles?
They clean the bowl so you don't have to. No, I didn't.
Yesterday, probably a little backstory for the listeners. You were telling us that you were covered in crap and you were a complete loser. Have I nailed the pertinent facts?
Well, let me emphasize to the listeners, those are your words, not mine.
Sorry, Billy Jack. So now you have a bunch of names of people who might actually have a photograph of you and your parents, right?
Right. I got a big bunch of names. So now I got to span the country to find all these people to see if anybody's got a photograph in that one day. Anderson, Anders, Asnoff, Aston. I mean, all these people on them tour buses that day? Belitnikov. It's gonna take forever, man, but I gotta do it.
Joe Dirt, I wish you luck. I hope you find what you're looking for. And remember that town you're always talking about.
Yeah, Silvertown, man.
Yes, Silvertown. You make it sound like the most wonderful place. So you've always got Silvertown. Remember that, Joe Dirt.
And you remember to keep on keeping on, man, and you'll be a veterinarian. Because I believe people get what they really, really want. Especially a cool guy like you kicking wing. You know what? You're my first real friend I found outside of Charlie and Brandy.
Oh, okay.
That's good. That hug was completely asexual. You know, he kind of snuck it up on me.
Whatever you gotta tell yourself, Joe Dirt.
I love you, Joe Dirt.
So I hit the road with my list of names, looking for tourists who might have photos of my folks. I hit pay dirt when I got a job with a traveling carnival. And that's when things got a little weird.
Come on, take a little walk with me, baby, and tell me who do you love? Who do you love?
I got you, buddy. Hey, who's this chick over here? Is that your girlfriend?
You should see my girlfriend. You'd shit yourself.
Really? Well, I tell you what, buddy. I'm going to give you a free spin. I'm going to talk to your lady friend over there. How about that?
Yes.
Good job, sir. Yeah, keep it straight like that. Good strategy. You know, the life of a carnival worker keeps me free and un...